continuing to go back to an abusive partner, you know, that you just keep going mm-hmm. back because you've been conditioned that this is normal and this is okay and it's acceptable, yep. you know, to keep going. What would you say to anyone right now that is in that place, and maybe they haven't even mentioned anything to anyone yet, but internally, their internal dialogue right now is, you know, what is this? Why all of a sudden do I feel differently? Why all of a sudden do I feel like I'm hurt instead of loved? Why am I starting to feel so lonely when up to this point, I always felt like I had this God, this thing, and I feel like I'm losing it. What would you say to that person?
Oh man. You know, everybody's different, and I'm so bad at giving advice, to be honest, just because I feel like I said, everybody's different. But if somebody is in a place where they think they believe in God or they're not sure, but they have a gut feeling, you know, they have this gut feeling that's leading them in a different way. We're taught in the church to never lean on our own understanding, to never trust our heart, because our heart will deceive us. And that one kept me in the dark for so long, because I was like, Satan's using my thoughts or my heart to trick me. But what I would tell someone who is in that position, and who is just, who doesn't know what to do, if there is a God, let's put a hypothetical on it. If there is a God and he is this loving Father God, that many Christians believe in, that he is full of grace and love and compassion, and he created you, he gave you intuition for a reason. And a good God would never punish you or damn you for following your instinct, for being, fair with your intellectual integrity, you know? If he's there and he wants you to know him, or he wants you to know something, he's going to give it to you. He's going to show it to you. And he's not going to hide and play games with you and give you hints that you can't see or that you miss. That's not going to happen. If you're being genuine in your search for truth, whatever that is, you might end up at the end of the day believing in God. You might not. That's okay either way. But as long as you're being genuine, a good God knows that. And he's not going to punish you for being genuine with yourself. And I think that's so important, to just understand that trusting yourself is not a sin. It's not wrong to trust yourself. Trusting myself has given me so much peace and happiness. And it's been a journey, and it takes a long time, but it's worth it. And at the end of the day, you only have yourself to trust and rely on. You see the writing on the wall.